Hi guys, welcome to our channel. And guys, today we will be sharing with you our experience of traveling with our baby. So in this video we'll be talking about the essentials you need to carry while traveling with your baby. So let's get started on this.
So guys, before we begin this video, let me tell you that we had moved to Canada in the month of August 2018. And our son was 6 months old back then. So all the experiences and shocks and surprises that we are sharing in this video is kept in mind that you are traveling on flight with a small baby. So let's get started on this.
So guys, the first and the important thing is the medicines. So I will recommend that you keep the medicines of your baby in the handbag itself, not in the check-in bag. You know, your baby may suffer from any kind of problem like colic problems, cold and cough problems. So those medicines should be there with you in your handbag.
So guys, the key here is that you need to anticipate in advance what all health problems your child may suffer in the flight, and you have to take precautions before that only. So just to give you an example guys, that my son had never been on a flight before. His first flight journey was from Mumbai to Toronto, and that was a non-stop flight. Since it was a very long flight, we had to anticipate all the things that could go wrong in the flight. So basically we were carrying medicines for fever, headache, body pain, any kind of motion sickness, loose motions, diarrhea, vomiting, and stuff like that. So what we had done is we basically went to our family doctor and also the child specialist and took a prescription and all the medicines that could be required for a child in such situations. And we carried all of them. So basically you have to carry the medicines, the prescription and the bill all together in your handbag, so you know exactly what medicine to give and in what dosage on the flight.
So guys, one more very 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 important thing: if you have infant with you, don't forget to carry the formula milk, because you won't be getting it in the flight. So you should always carry the formula milk with you. You may be asked at the security counter to show it, but baby food is always allowed, so don't worry about that. So carry the formula milk and don't carry the hot water, because you will get the hot water anyways in the flight. So yeah, please.
Along with the formula milk, you need to carry a small bowl and some plastic spoons, the small ones, so that your baby can be easily fed, that you won't be able to get it on the flight. And if you get it, will be for the adults, not for the kids. So it's better that you carry your baby's own set of bowls and spoons so that he can be properly fed.
Yeah, also because of hygiene purpose, you carry your own cutlery. So just make sure that you don't forget all these things.
Yeah. Guys, one more important thing that we need to add here is that during the takeoff and landing, there is a problem of clogged ears in adults. The same problem is there with kids as well. It's just that they cannot express, and also because of the loud sound, they may start crying. So guys, always make sure that you cover your baby's ears with either cotton plugs, or you give them, and also give them something to chew. So if your baby is really small toddler or in the teething stage, do carry teethers with you so that he can just keep on chewing it, so that the ears don't get clogged.
Guys, always dress your babies in warm clothing, because the temperature inside the flight is always cold. So make sure they feel comfortable and warm, they are warm every time. And also carry your own blanket, because I know you will be getting the blanket in the flight, but for hygiene purpose I will recommend that you carry your baby's blanket with you. And also in case you need, you should always carry extra plastic bags. You will be getting the diaper bags, no problem with that, but to be on the safer side, you should always carry extra plastic bags with you. Guys, you should always carry 4 to 5 extra set of clothes for your baby. Babies can spill anything on their clothes. So instead of bathing them all the time or cleaning them, you should always change their clothes. So better to take extra clothes with you, so that in case you need them, you can always change.
And also guys, along with extra set of clothes, all you need to carry is extra set of diapers as well. As she told that it will not be possible to bathe your baby in the flight, but you need to change diapers frequently. having said that, you should always carry at least 10 to 12 diapers in your purse or your handbag. And along with that, you should also be taking diaper rash cream and your baby powder, so that your baby gets, you know, that fresh feeling, and he can also enjoy his or her flight journey.
Yeah, also don't forget the baby wipes, because you need to clean them for the hygiene purpose. So diapers, rash cream, the baby wipes, extra set of hankies whenever you need them, or tissue papers. So yeah guys, be prepared for everything.
And a small bottle of hand sanitizer also.
Yeah.
It is good for you.
So guys, one more important thing is that you should always carry a few favorite toys of your baby's choice. So in case you have infants, so you can carry soft toys or teethers to keep them engrossed. Or if your kids are a little bit big, you can always have playing cards or coloring books to keep them busy, so that they don't get bored, and you know, they should be in the playful mood. So yeah, please try to keep them happy as much as possible, so they don't disturb other passengers or disturb you while traveling. Yeah.
Also guys, one more thing that you need to take care is, if you carry some of the sound emitting toys for your babies, like the typical ones which has got the LED lights with some sound coming when you press the button or something like that, make sure that you put it on the lower volume so that you don't disturb other passengers. Also, since it's a battery operated toy, you should be declaring it at the security, since there are certain restrictions on the battery operated items that you can carry on the flight. They will be permitting it, but it's better that you declare it upfront rather than being asked at a later time. So just take care guys. Guys, the next important thing that you need to consider is the baby bassinet. But also take care that all the flights may not have the number of bassinets equal to the number of babies in the flight. Say for example, in the flight that we were traveling, there were only two bassinets, and the total number of babies only in the economy class was around 10 or 11. So you know, there was not enough bassinets for to accommodate all the babies, and we had to carry our son in our hands for the whole 16-hour flight journey. Having said that, you should consider sitting near the washroom area and on the aisle seat, so that you don't disturb other passengers when you want to take your baby to the washroom to change his diapers or anything like that. Also, being seated closer to the washroom area also ensures that you are closer to the lavatory, which means that if you need air hostess's help, you will be able to get to them closer, or they'll be able to come to you in a faster way.
Yeah, right.
So please do take care of this particular thing.
So guys, you should always carry umbrella stroller with you in the flight, because you know, you cannot, in case you have a one-stop flight and you need to get down, so you cannot hold your baby all the time, you know, so it's better to carry the umbrella stroller, so you can keep it in the cabin, so, luggage. And in case you are traveling with the bigger strollers, always check with the dimensions, you know, because every airline have dimension criteria. So if the stroller is big enough, then you can always get it checked in. And one more tip is that whenever you are traveling with a baby, you should always come 3 to 4 hours earlier before your flight duration. So in case you have those like baby products with you, you can always get them checked in. And if you come at the last time, the people, you know, the flight people may refuse to take it.
Yeah. So guys, to add to this, one more surprising experience for us was, so we were 2 adults and 1 child traveling. So technically we had 5 check-in bags to be that we could carry.
Yeah.
However, the airline staff was so generous that they checked in 8 of our bags and 1 stroller.
Yes.
So guys, we were left with just 1 backpack. She was having 1 purse and I just had 1 small bag in which all baby's medicines and clothes were left. So basically, the point that I want to tell you is that travel as lightly as you can with your kid, so that you know, you are you can move easily in the flight, and you know, anywhere in the airport you can move very easily. Also, if you reach early to the airport, you can request the airline to give you more allowance as far as your baggage is concerned, and you can get that bags checked in for free.
So that advantage we took, because we arrived almost like 4 hours before the flight time.
Yeah.
So yeah.
And to add to it, the flight was delayed by 2 hours. So
yeah.
6 hours we had to stay on the airport.
Mm.
And but the airline was really good. They were considerate enough of giving us that free allowance, so that we could travel, with very less items on our hand.
Yeah, because traveling with a baby and with too much of luggage is like
really, is really difficult.
Yeah.
Guys, once you have boarded the flight and you are comfortably seated in your seat, you should be asking the air hostess for checking whether the seat on which you are seated has got that one extra oxygen mask for your baby. So guys, what happens is, all the seat configurations, they have equal number of oxygen masks on the top. So in case of emergency depressurization in the cabin, the oxygen masks would drop for you to breathe normally. However, if you are sitting with your baby, there should be one extra oxygen mask above your seat for the baby. Now, not all seats have this configuration, but yeah, some seats do have that extra oxygen mask. So make sure that you are seated on that seat which has that oxygen mask. So air hostesses would be the perfect person who would be knowing whether that extra oxygen mask is available or no. And it's a part of their duty and they would be telling it to you upfront. However, if they don't do, it is your responsibility that you go and ask them. So, you know, you just to be doubly sure that you and your baby are safe in the flight. Guys, now coming to the safety instructions. In all the airlines, there are brace positions which is defined for adults as well as for kids. Just make sure that you are well known about the brace positions for kids, and the air hostesses would be telling it to you, but just make sure that you are updated from them about the different brace positions in case of an emergency. So that's it for the day, guys. And hope you all like this video. If you really do, please do like, comment and subscribe, and do let us know in your comments if you have any other suggestions for us. And that's it.
Yeah. Travel safely with your babies.
And wish you happy journey.
Yeah.
And bye. Take care, guys. Bye.